Well, there's a story I'd like to share. Come out of the book of Luke, chapter 10. And it is called the parable of the Good Samaritan. Parable of the Good Samaritan. Luke chapter 10. We're going to start with verse 25. Now, keep your seat for me. Because what I want to do is let's read. Have you stand up and let's read 25, 26, and 27. You'll stand up and read, and we'll read these three verses together, and then I will finish it. Luke chapter 10, verse 25, 26, and you'll read with me 25, 26, and 27. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he asked, "what must I do to inherit eternal life? But what must I do that I might live on? What do I do?" And Jesus replied, "What is written in the law?" He replied, "And how do you read it?" He answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself." You may be seated.
Right.
Now, Tion, stay with me here. Me and you are going to go all the way down to verse 36. 28. "You have, answered correctly," Jesus replied. "Do this and you will live." But he wanted, talking about the guy that asked the question, the lawyer, and he wanted to justify himself. And so he asked Jesus, "Well, who is my neighbor?" In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, where he fell into the hands of robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So, too, a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, he passed on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his clothes, his wounds, and poured on oil and wine. And then he put the man on his own donkey and took him to an inn and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 silver coins and gave them to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have."
Right.
Jesus now poses the question, which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers? Amen.
Amen.
Which of these three. Grace. The priest. He moved over the Levite. He moved over. Brother, that's a good Samaritan. That's a good Samaritan. Levite. Samaritan came. And Jesus said, which of these, which of the three was a good Samaritan? Christians, as Christians, that's what we are. We are Christian men and women. And we are often troubled when we are faced with that person. Where do our obligation start in terms of being a good neighbor? Well, where does our obligation start? And where does it stop when we began to talk about helping other people? Where does your obligation start and where does it stop in terms of you being a good neighbor to other people? We all know too well there are times when we do things, help folks. In fact, I read an article a couple of months ago in the Oklahoma that talked about panhandlers. And it talked about panhandlers, and I know out on Northwest Expressway, if you get off there on Northwest Expressway, off of 44, they have to be at the hospital. Panhandlers is on all four corners.
Yes, sir.
They're there every day. And they got there asking, we're hungry. Some of the signs are we are veterans and we can't find jobs and all of the things that would tear and toll at your heart.
Right.
Those signs are there. But on the other side of the coin, there's people saying, when I read in the paper, listen, you've got to be careful because some of those folks are taking you for a ride.
Right.
Yeah. You are being exploited. Well, yeah, that could be true. That could be true. Yeah, but the fact of the matter, the conclusion that Mother Basin that I came to was simply because I do not have enough information and I cannot stop my car and go out and give them an application or to check and see if they're really hungry, I have to make what I call a judgment call. And when I make it for myself, I'm selfish.
All right.
When I think of myself,
yes, sir.
I become selfish, and I won't give a damn.
Right.
Because I believe what somebody else told me.
Right.
I didn't follow what God put in my spirit. He says to do, and the rest of it is on. You will always run the risk, always, even in your family.
All right.
And I'm just talking about what I'm talking about, because see, I got a big family, and I know I know how it works and how they do it. I know Carl when you see it. I know Gabe down the road. I've been there, done that. So you always.